It's your boy Judea, Black Shalom L'Chaim, purified drink of water. They got it, it's out there. Shouts out to the 12 tribes. I got it, it's right there. Okay, so we was talking about the right field. So this is the beginning of the right fields. And the only reason I'm calling them right field, because we was talking about, right field, excuse me. Because we were talking about the being black in Israel. So what we're going to do now is actually going to talk about some other stuff. And oh, and I know you heard my new, that music I like is all slowed down and or chopped and screwed type. I kind of like it like that for this whole little right field thing. So that's what that's going to be. It's may catch light, may catch low. Either way it go, it got a little soul in it. You know what I mean? So what I'm getting about this whole little right field thing is we're going to talk about Emancipation Proclamation, Emmett Till. We're about to talk about the... hold on, I got a list of stuff right here. We're about to talk about the black codes. We're about to talk about the cold facts. We're about to talk about 40 acres in a mule, poverty, special field order 15, objective 8, and all that stuff. We're about to get into all of that with this right field thing. So that's what that is. And like I said, you're going to stand for Israel, you got to stand for Palestine. If you're going to stand for Palestine, you got to stand for Israel, because we support the people and not the cause. And I hope today found you safer than yesterday did. And I hope tomorrow finds you safer than today and the day before. Like I said, we inside today because we got to be. So that's just what it is. So we're running these right field things. So welcome to the right field. And hey, stop. 20-something videos, man. This right field about the wrong one. So let's get straight into it. The audio we about to get into just to start this whole little right field thing off is we're going to get into American law. Or just American law. Something like that. And yeah, check out them waters down there. Got that package floating around here. Y'all got it out there. Email me if you can get no water. We will talk. We can talk lineage, we can talk heritage, we can talk whatever we want to talk. Let's talk. Through emails, emails only. Shouts out to the 12 tribes, man. 200 thou out there. There's a couple pathalones floating around. I hope they find everybody safe. Okay, anyway. Yeah, so this first video is American law. All right, are the right fields? American law. I said I was going to do this like this. Cue that music I like. American privilege keeps burning my vision. Inherited sickness. Every day I piss money away. I'm a material slave. Trying to promise this ball in this chain. Cause I don't think twice.
I got a question for y'all. Why is it that it's not mandatory to learn the law in school? If this is something that dictates our presence in America. I gotta close the blinds because they ain't gonna like this. This is the story of a little boy who had a stuttering problem who visited his great uncle's house. He ends up getting abducted from his home. Killed, mutilated, his eyes were gouged out, shot, and he was 14 years old. All because this woman said that he whistled at her. Now, these demons who killed him, they did not go to jail and they were convicted, not guilty. We got 50 plus years going by. She ends up saying, oh, he didn't whistle at me. I lied. Now, when we try to bring this case back, the grand jury declines to indict her, right? But this little boy died. She is still alive, but she's not in jail now. Let me ask y'all, why do y'all think Karens exist? And yes, they were existing back then, putting false accusations on black people. They know that these laws are made against us. That's why they use it to apprehend us. They made laws to catch runaway slaves. They made laws to say that we cannot vote. We have to take literacy tests. We can't live in specific places. They have upgraded and created these amendments to seem ethical. But the same situations keep happening. These laws and the original constitution and everything that plays a part with that was never meant for us. Therefore, it can never work for people of color. Black Panther activist Angela Davis was wrongfully convicted of murder and the FBI was looking for her. Like I said, creating laws so they can take you. She ends up beating the case. Before the FBI to even accuse these things of her and legally try to kidnap her, that shows that they can do whatever they want. It's the same thing with Asada Shakur. Now let's just listen to her words.
The FBI, with the help of local police agencies, systematically fed false accusations and fake news articles to the press, accusing me and other activists of crimes we did not commit.
This happened 20 plus 30 years ago and they still want her head.
National and local police agencies created a situation where, based on their false accusations against me, any police officer could shoot me on sight.
Now the things that are done to our people in the name of the law, being shot 60 times unarmed, and this is all the law has to say.
Or why officers initially deployed non-lethal tasers.
I don't know. I'm not going to respond to that because it would be speculation.
A police chief saying he doesn't know why. That's all the answers we get, according to the law.
A program that was set up by the Federal Bureau of Investigation to eliminate all political opposition to the U.S. government's policies to destroy the Black Liberation Movement in the United States.
And that is the dark history of law. Y'all stay dangerous always. This is going to be really hard for me to talk about, so bear with me.
It's finna get dark in here.
We are going to talk about the dark history on why jails were created. In 1863, African American slaves were freed. They thought things were great, but they really just got backstabbed. Now, as you know, in 1861 and 1865, the American Civil War happened. During the Civil War, roughly 179,000 black men fought in the Civil War. They fought in the war because they thought America would look out for them. Which ultimately made them worry, because now how do we keep these people in control? The government needed a way to create peace. To keep the white people happy, but also take care of the African-American citizens that just got freed. Before the 1890s, where they started the Prison Act, jails and prisons tend to look like houses. Some like this. After the American Civil War, the number of U.S. penitentiaries in the South and West spiked. So, who y'all finna put in there? After this, a lot of African-Americans were locked up. Their inmates population surpassed 30,000. By 1880s, African-Americans became the major inmates. They were backstabbed. You're telling me that they helped fight the war and then they were falsely imprisoned to do more labor. Convicts, who were originally slaves, dug levees, laid railroad tracks, picked cotton and mined coals for private companies and planters. Mostly false imprisonment or doing more time than they deserved. Innocent man locked up for 37 years. 1944, George Steeney, 14-year-old, electrocuted and he was innocent. We're still living in this dark history, and Joe Biden played a part in it. Your president signed a crime bill what was one of the key contributions to mass incarcerations in the 1990s, especially hurting blacks and brown Americans. African Americans, they were never really freed. It just was switched. Black people were never given equality. Let's just clear that up. African Americans have been fighting for decades for equality from the government. Everybody be safe out there. Now today, we are going to talk about the dark history of the police.
Under martial law, they can't show up to my doorstep.
Just to make this clear, in no way, shape, or form am I promoting hate or prejudice against anybody. There are good people and there are bad people. This is dark, so I will not whitewash this. Let's go down the timeline, shall we? Before the formal police system, there were people called the Night's Watch, constables, sheriffs, and slave patrol. Before the fight between Republicans and Democrats, the fight between free states and slave states. So they all had their own individual laws. So now that we understand the separation of America, we can understand the separation of police. You know, the good cops and the bad cops. But today we're talking about the dark history, so we're going to talk about the bad cops. Originally, slave patrol originated in the early 1700s with one mission. Establish a system of terror and squash slave uprising in the capacity to pursue, apprehend, and return runaway slaves to their owners. Because, you know, we weren't considered people. They had to make sure slaves weren't wandering out at night trying to run away, you know. So there was an issue because there wasn't unity. The northern and the southern states were beefing. The southern states wanted to assert their authority over federal government so they could abolish federal laws they didn't support, i.e. wanting to keep slavery. So civil war happened and declared that all personal people who held slaves with the rebellious states are henceforward shall be free. So there was no need to run or fear for your life, right? So this became this, but it was still the same thing. I can't even show the pictures that I want to show, but even after that, a lot of African Americans were still terrorized. So now that slave patrols were not allowed, these people became the police to assert their dominance because of the prejudice that they had. An example of this is called lynching. Violent public acts that white people used to terrorize and control black people in the 19th and 20th century. Hanging them from trees, but they also involved extreme brutality such as torture, mutilation, decapitation, and desecration. Some of them were burnt alive. Now a lot of people are wondering why there are bad cops. Because the same people who were slave catchers became police, and then their children's children had children, their children's children had children, and then we all are just dealing with this American problem. I wanted to squeeze in as much information as I could, but you know, it just gets too deep. Just wanted to put a spark in your brain, but I will make more videos on this. Y'all be safe with these bad cops. Y'all just watch this real quick.
If you have a problem figuring out whether you're for me or Trump, and you ain't black.
Okay, Joe, since you want to take it there, we can take it there. Today we're going to talk about the dark history of the Democrats. Now, before I start, I want to let you know that I have no bias against anybody. You do what you want, you believe in what you want. And no, I do not identify with any political party. I'm just stating the dark history. Mutilation, whipping, drowning, castration, buck breaking, terrorism, and torture. 246 years went by before y'all even got involved in that. Y'all remember that terrorist group Ku Klux Klan? Founded by Nathan Bedford Forrest, who was the Grand Wizard and a Democrat. Didn't Eric Foner, a Democrat, argue that the KKK was a military arm of Democratic Party in the South? Y'all wanna know who wasn't a Democrat? Abraham Lincoln, a Republican, who passed laws that said we are not slaves, we deserve the right to be citizens, and we have a right to vote. Now what political party voted against this? Democrat. Didn't bro assassinate Abraham Lincoln? He sure as heck wasn't a Republican. I see when y'all don't get y'all way, y'all start to get dangerous. After black people were freed, they went on the Republican side because they knew what was going on with the Democrats. So y'all started to terrorize them. Y'all remember that trial deciding whether or not we had the right to be citizens? Didn't all y'all decide and vote to say we wasn't? Y'all put this man's face on a $20 bill. A Democrat who enforced the Indian Removal Act in the 1830s expelling Native Americans out of their homes. Wasn't majority of the Southern states Democrats? Didn't y'all identify y'all as the white man's party? Didn't y'all enforce Jim Crow policies? Democrats use intimidation taxes to suppress black voters. Literacy tests, poll taxes, protests against us even trying to vote, owning property, and then when y'all got cool with us starting to vote. Didn't the Democratic president say he'll have us voting for the next 200 years? Oh yeah, he put that N-word in there too. There go your boy, sitting with him, devising tactics to get the black people in the Democratic Party. So here's the list. Defended slavery, started the Civil War, oppressed Reconstruction, founded the Ku Klux Klan, imposed segregation, and fought the Civil Rights Act. Oh yeah, don't forget about that too. All I'm saying is just be safe with these people. Do y'all want to know why it was so important for them to force us to convert to Christianity? Not because they wanted to spread an enlightenment and the good word, but because they were very afraid of us. I'm pretty sure y'all heard of the Haitian Revolution. Oh, you know where black people fought against the French and won. They were so nervous, they even made laws.
1685, a law in Haiti prohibited the practice of African religions and forced slave owners to actually push their slaves to adapt the Christian faith within 8 days.
Now, I really want to just ask this question. Y'all got knives, bayonets, swords, pistols, muskets, rifles, canyons, bombs. So here's the big question. How did enslaved people with no upgraded weapons fight and beat against these people? Well, this is Cecile Fatima, and she was a Haitian voodoo priestess. And she did a voodoo ceremony to summon the strength to win against these colonizers. A week later, 18,000 plantations were destroyed, and 1,000 slaveholders got what they deserved. Now, I can see why these colonizers want to demonize their practices. I mean, imagine seeing people like this, doing these ceremonies, converting their energy to fight against you. Very strongly put in the Bible, slaves, be obedient to your human master with fear and tremble in the sincerity of heart as to Christ. There were instances of colonizers' teeth falling out through battle, stomach pains, headaches, issues within the colonizer soldiers. I mean, look at this. The Chief Justice President Judge lost his voice and had to adjourn court. Then the President of Legislative Council died. When court was resumed, the judge again lost his voice and he had difficulty speaking. The jury believed to have supernatural interventions. They do not like the personal, spiritual, and ancestral power that we were using to protect us. Voodoo means spirit. They had to erase our spirit, our strength, in order for us to be docile. Because what was done in Haiti shook the foundation of owning slaves. But you know, y'all stay dangerous.